At the time, I had 127 correspondents around the world. I was also in correspondence with a number of the early authors like Jack Williamson and Edgar Rice Burroughs. And finally, in 1939, at the first World Science Fiction Convention, I met in person authors I had been corresponding with called Ray Cummings and, the fabulous artist Frank R. Paul, David H. Keller. He was one of my favorite early authors, and at one time I visited him in his home in Pennsylvania, and I stayed overnight, and I noticed at each meal he was including a handful of different vitamins, and he said he was attempting to lengthen his life with these. He did indeed live to a ripe old age. My wife didn't believe in vitamins. She said, you eat a healthy diet and that's sufficient. Well, Francis Flagg was a well-established name author, but he began to run out of ideas. And I was overflowing with ideas, but I did not have any stature yet as an author, so I began supplying plots to Francis Flagg, and he wrote up, the first one was called Earth Lucky Day. Well, I remember at one time when I was temporarily living in San Francisco, I found that an author of a series of stories called Tanny of Ekis. He had the name of Aladra Septama. And I found that actually he was a lawyer, Judson W. Reeves, living in, having his office in downtown San Francisco. So one day I went to his office and met him, and he took me to lunch afterwards and out to his home, and there I was staggered to see the first six issues of Amazing Stories on display. I had not been aware of it in April 1926 when it began, and I only began collecting it in October, and to my undying gratitude, Aladra Septama. I always fascinated by that pseudonym. I regret I didn't ask him how he created such a name, but Aladra Septama took the six copies of Amazing Stories that I had missed and gained my undying gratitude by making me a gift of them.
I bet you still have them, too.
Do you still have them?
Of course I have them. I never threw away a science fiction magazine in my life.